Welcome to the 8th episode of Qapsule. Let's consume, learn and excel. A digital series dedicated to enrich your understanding about quality concepts at Tata Steel. Today's topic is overall equipment effectiveness. OEE gives an idea of the maximum output that's practically possible from a given production system. The term OEE was first coined by Saichi Nakajima, who is the pioneering founder of the total productive maintenance methodology. It gives a measure of how well a given asset is optimized as compared to its full potential. This understanding is crucial because machines tend to lose their effectiveness over time due to wear and tear and obsolescence. Continuous improvement in OEE is considered a goal in TPM. Before we get to the components of OEE, we need to look at the six major losses of TPM occurring in a typical manufacturing facility. If a machine is scheduled to run for one shift in a factory, it won't necessarily be productive for all the 8 hours. The loss factors are the individual pieces that subtract from a perfect OEE score of 100%. These loss factors are availability loss, performance loss, and quality loss. Availability loss is derived from planned and unplanned stops during plant production time. A planned stop is a period of changeover or a make-ready event like replacing of dies, jigs, fixtures, and other components of the machine for the next job to be processed, during which no value is produced. An unplanned stop is a stop due to a mechanical failure, power outages, repair, any unplanned maintenance activity, or any external losses beyond control which halts production. Performance loss considers small stops and slow cycles during production. A small stop, also called a minor stop or idling, is counted as any pause in production that's not significant enough to be tracked as stop time. It may be due to operator unavailability, incompetent operator, or when the raw material charge is exhausted and needs replacement. A slow cycle is any cycle that takes longer than the ideal cycle time, which is a theoretical maximum speed at which a discrete item may be produced. These occur due to wear and tear of the machines over long run. Quality loss refers to the loss incurred by faulty parts, including rework parts. This is measured as a combination of startup loss and process loss. Startup loss includes all defective parts produced from startup until equipment reaches stable production. Process loss includes any defective part made once the production is stable. A rework part is a part that, although initially rejected, can be fixed and sold to the customer. These six losses of TPM lay the foundation for the components of OEE. How to calculate OEE? Let's see how it's done. Given the many different variables that go into it, it isn't surprising that there are also many ways to describe interplay of the various losses. And because of its time-based nature, the terms describe loss in relation to the big six losses and total time as shown on left of the screen. Total time covers the entire duration of workday. Equipment functioning and planned production time is defined as total time minus schedule losses. Operating time is the duration of time during which equipment is actively producing value, ignoring small stops and idling. Net operating time is operating time minus performance loss. It is the most detailed measure of time loss due to equipment not functional at optimum capacity, which may be due to small stops. Finally, fully productive time is defined as net operating time minus quality loss. This metric takes net operating time and discounts any time during production where loss was incurred by creating a defective part due to wastages. The ratio of fully productive time to planned production time is how OEE is calculated. Resulting number is a percentage out of 100, which considers every loss as it compounds. Let's see an example to understand this much better. In a particular month, a factory has been functional for 25 working days, running one shift. Factory deploys one machine, which is not in operation for 20 minutes every day due to setup changes. Machine operator takes a lunch break of 30 minutes every day. Due to aging, machine runs at 80% of its rated speed and rejection rate of the process is 7%. As factory is functional for 25 days, for that month scheduled loss is 5 days. Planned production time is 25 days into 8 hours a day, considering one shift operation, which makes it 200 hours. Availability loss is setup time plus downtime. That is equal to 20 minutes setup plus 30 minutes lunch break, that's 50 minutes a day. Considering 25 days planned production time, this is equal to 20.83 hours. So, availability A is 89.6%. Machine is running at 80% of rated speed, hence performance P is 80%. Defect rate is 7% as mentioned. So, quality yield Y is 93%. OEE is a multiplication of availability, performance and quality yield, which is 66.67%. So where is OEE applicable? It is especially useful when one is trying to locate pain areas in one's production system. By determining exactly which component is problematic, it can help make the process of system optimization much easier. It also facilitates quantification of inadequacies in the production system. On the other hand, it has several limitations. Biggest drawback of OEE is that it is better representative in continuous production type setups where changeovers are minimal. As a result, OEE comparison between a system with no changeover and a system with frequent changeovers is meaningless. It considers one machine at a time. Profitability of a firm depends on several factors apart from production. And OEE does not consider any of those factors external to manufacturing system. Thus, it isn't a holistic measure of performance and does not directly link to productivity. Hope this episode has enhanced your knowledge about OEE. Stay tuned for future episodes.